Hello everybody and welcome to this amazing guide to one-on-one Joust Mage builds. In this guide we're going to go over how to balance your build offensively and defensively. This should give you the ability to deal effective damage and survive against any burst damage or other high damaging characters. So let's begin with how the foundation of every Joust build is. Every Joust build should include the following foundation: one movement speed item, one penetration item, a defensive item, power item, and two situational items that you can interchange to adapt to the situation. With every mage build, boots are incorporated as our movement item. There are two boots that are highly debated upon, which is the Shoes of the Magi and Shoes of Focus for penetration or cooldown. But before you pick your boots, it's important to know how much they truly affect you and your play. Looking at the magical penetration from Shoes of the Magi, 15 magical penetration sounds great, however this equates to approximately 11% damage increase when an opponent does not build any magical protection. However, when your opponent finally builds their one magical protection item against you up to 100, the Boots of the Magi will only provide a 5% damage increase instead of the 11. It is important to note that Boots of the Magi does not scale well if the opponent builds protections, and knowing our opponent should build at least one defensive item, the boots will not be as effective as we originally intended it to be. As for Shoes of the Focus, it is the only mage item that provides 15% cooldown. Combined with Chronos Pendant or Breastplate of Valor, it provides maximum cooldown for your abilities, which is 40%. For a one-on-one joust, I would always recommend cooldown as your boots of choice for that purpose. Let's give you a demonstration on the difference between penetration boots and cooldown boots. My opponent, Habwa, has Shoes of the Magi, and I have Shoes of Focus. So we're going to begin by showing the power difference between each attack, and then I'll go over the cooldowns. As you can see, there wasn't a very big difference between basic attacks, but as we started to use our spells, there was a good increase of damage that he was dealing to me. But I have the minimum amount of protection that a mage will provide, so we're going to now try it with protection. Now that Habwa and I both have our protections up to 95, we couldn't use the Gaia Stone I wanted. It really messes with the chat log when you have Gaia Stone, because it keeps saying that you get healed. So for this purpose, I'm just going to use Pestilence, which is the second highest I could get my defense up to with one item. But it should be sufficient enough. So we're going to go ahead and begin now showing the damage that you get with pen boots and cooldown boots when your opponent finally has their defense. And as you can see, the difference has kind of closed the gap a little bit, and the boots aren't working to their fullest potential that they were when I did not have defense. So Shoes of the Focus dropped my cooldowns to 2.5, 8.5, and 76.5 from 3, 10, and 90. So this is a drastic difference with only 15%, and comboed with a Chronos Pendant or Breastplate of Valor, I could drop them even further, allowing me to cast at a greater rate. So when it comes to it, you gotta judge whether or not your opponent really is going to build that defense. Your pen boots are beautiful when they don't, because you get that additional damage, and when you're amplifying your damage, that 11% makes a huge difference. However, when your opponent has defense, you could just go to your penetration item instead to get through that and deal more damage, and that's what we're going to talk about next. Penetration is a vital part of your build. You only have so much space in your build to utilize power and penetration with defense. Obsidian Shard is the typical recommendation for most mages, however there are other ways for specific mages to utilize Spear of the Magus. One item I really need to point out to everybody to avoid building while in a one-on-one joust is Voidstone. Voidstone lacks power, it lacks high penetration, and it lacks magical protection. 50 is not bad, 50 jumps you up to 80, but other items that will jump you up to almost 100 makes a large difference for your protection purposes and the percentage in which you are going to reduce. On top of that, enemies that finally penetrate that 50 protection, you'll probably be back down to the 30 by then. So it's very important that you get your protections as high to 100 as you can. Therefore, Voidstone lacks in all areas where we are building one item for each area. So just try to avoid this to the best of your ability. As a side note about Obsidian Shard, it's very important to know that it does not scale very well at all if your opponent does not build any protections. However, you will always deal more damage to towers, phoenixes, and titans with Obsidian Shard. But when it comes to fighting your opponents, Shoes of the Magi, when they build no protections, will give you a lot more damage than an Obsidian Shard. So when you are faced with that situation, it might be better to go with the Shoes of the Magi to get the penetration to defeat your opponent and replace Obsidian Shard with another power item in order to burst them down in return. So it's very important to keep an eye on your opponent's build. I know that boots are usually built very early, but they're easy to replace if you see that your opponent has gotten 6 items without any defense. Every build needs power, but there are two items that do very well to provide some of the most power you can get. Ra Tahiti and Book of Thoth are the two items you can use to fill this slot. Ra Tahiti is the highest raw damage, whereas Book of Thoth provides high damage, not as much as Ra Tahiti, but also gives you a high mana pool, MP5, and power. If your god consumes a lot of mana, or should you have to sustain while poking your opponent at their phoenix or tower, Rod of Tahiti might not be the best choice, as Book of Thoth will give you the sustaining power to continuously cast spells and poke them while they're at their phoenix. However, Rod Tahiti is more for pure power, high burst if you need it. So if you do not need the mana, you can exchange it for the Rod Tahiti to deal as much damage as possible and kill your opponent with little effort. It is very important to remember that both of these items are weaker at the start of the game than they are later in the game. So attempt to build it later, get it around your 4th to 6th item. Book of Thoth really does well at maximum level. At 20 it'll, you have your most mana and it gives you the most power, whereas Ra Tahiti, when it's at the end of your build, you have all of your power and you probably get damage buff and a consumable to increase your power even more. Taking a quick look at the difference with my current build and my opponent's current build, Ra Tahiti is giving my opponent 306 power, whereas a max stacks Book of Thoth is giving me 296. And though this isn't the greatest difference in power, we haven't yet built a lot of power for his Rod of Tahiti to build more power on top of what he's already given. So with that, his Rod Tahiti, as we get later into the game, will deal more damage, but currently Book of Thoth is keeping up very well. When it comes to protections, you can only afford to get one item of protection before scaling is diminished and you have to sacrifice power for a minimal increase of defense. So for protection, you want to get it to about 100 protection, which will provide you 50% damage reduction. This is an attempt to counter small amounts of flat penetration and keeps you a bit protected from items like Obsidian Shard. Even if your opponent were to get Obsidian Shard, you will still have increased damage reduction than you did in the beginning of the game. When it comes to a defensive item, I suggest Gaia Stone is one of the best counters for any mage in the game, being this will provide you sustainability, it will provide you high protection, and your opponent will need to buy an Obsidian Shard to get through to you. However, when facing a physical opponent, Breastplate of Valor is a better choice, as it does provide you the 25% cooldown, and mixed with Shoes of Focus, it gets you that 40% of maximum cooldown. So looking at it, both ways, you can either get a Gaia Stone or a Breastplate of Valor, depending if you're fighting a physical or magical character. As an additional note, for defense, Witchblade happens to be one of the awkward defensive items you can buy. And the reason I say it's awkward is it doesn't provide you the physical protection a lot of other items will, but it provides you movement speed, and this is very important. When your opponent cannot hit you with basic attacks, when they're a physical, high damaging, basic attack character, if they cannot hit you because they cannot catch you, their basic attacks are null and void, and you do not need any kind of defense, being they aren't dealing any damage to you. This might not always be the case, as your opponent may find a way to catch you, but if you need the movement speed over defense, Witchblade is a fantastic choice. A few other notable physical items to look at are Neiman, Height of the Neiman Lion, which will provide you 20% reflection to all basic attacks, and that can be very important when fighting a high lifesteal character. Height of the Neiman Lion will provide you reflection damage, which counters their lifesteal, so it lets you deal more damage as they are hitting you. You still need to be aware if they try to attack your minions to get a little lifesteal off them. And finally, Midgardian Mail, which is fantastic for characters that are always in your face. This can provide you a slow and slow down their attack speed to give you an opportunity to breathe. Which defensive item for physical you go with is up to you and how you wish to play. There are certain items I would never suggest, such as obviously Sovereignty. It gives you magical protections. It does give an additional 20, so you get a total of 85 physical protection, but overall, its utility isn't as grand as you could with Neiman Lion to counter the Lifesteal or Midgardian Mail to slow your opponent, or even a Breastplate of Valor to increase your cooldowns. And then also looking at Celestial Helm, which is a kind of an anti-crit helm. It's very rare you'll find an opponent that does crit in a one-on-one joust, and by the time that you have crits, stopping them for 3 seconds is not going to give you enough time to kill them, as they will probably have killed you in a couple of basic attacks. So it's important to keep in mind that Celestial Legion Helm is a very supportive item over a one-on-one joust item. Finally, our last two items of our build are situational and interchangeable, and you can make them whatever you want. I have a couple of suggestions that might help you out, but it's really up to you and your opponent. So let's begin. My situational item I always get on every god, almost, is Warlock Sash. It's both offensive, defensive. It's my starting item. It's not weak. It's not, it's not the worst starting item, but it's not the most powerful. It provides you a lot of power compared to a lot of items and gives you 600 health at max stacks, which is beautiful. Then I always go with a Chronos Pendant to finish, which gives me my max cooldowns if I'm fighting a mage, or else I would swap my Gaia's Stone for a Valor and switch my Chronos Pendant out for whatever other item I need. You can use these interchangeable items if, for example, if I was fighting a physical god and had Valor in place of my Gaia's Stone, I could get Rod of Tahiti to become more powerful. On my opponent's build here, I have more of a bursty damage with Soul Reaver. Soul Reaver is a very good burst damage. If you're looking to kill your opponent with one combo, this deals 15% of their maximum health and additional damage. It's also very important to note that the damage is not mitigated, meaning it's true. You deal 15%, it cannot be reduced. It can be blocked if immune, of course, but that is situational for you again. Lifesteal goes in these slots. Like if you're trying to get Bancroft's Talent for Lifesteal, Divine Ruin to counter healing, it's completely up to you guys. It's also very important to remember that these builds are not built in this particular order. This is just a foundation for you guys to help guide you to build the right build. So in order to help you guys, this is how I build this build. It's a Warlock Sash is my starter item. It gives me both offensive and defensive start. Then boots are always my second, and I always go with Shoes of Focus unless I'm playing one or two specific gods. So then after that, I look at my opponent's build to see what they went. If they went with what I did, then I will continue to follow up with a power item, which is my Book of Thoth. However, if they went defensive, I would rush my Obsidian Shard. But I always try to get Book of Thoth between 4 to 5. Sometimes I'll get my defense if I feel that I need it. Or if I'm playing Hell, for example, I will rush Chronos Pendant, which is my second situational item. Again, completely up to you guys how you do it, but it's very important for you to know your foundation, what you need by the end of the game, but how you get there is up to you and how the momentum of the game is flowing. Thank you everybody for watching. Hopefully this guide helps you guys out in building for your mages. Like, comment, subscribe, and as always, good game.